echoes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now.
There goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now.
I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean
just to be with you, and fix what I've broken.
Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason.
There goes my head shaking, and you are the reason my heart keeps bleeding. I need you now.
If I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. I'd spend every
everyone. My name is Pastor Troy, and on behalf of Christopher and Shauna and the families, I'd like to thank you for your presence here today as we bring this home, this family, into existence. These two young, fabulous young people coming together as one. So I get the privilege of giving you some instructions right now. So if you haven't already, this is an unplugged service, so we're taking a break from technology right now. So if you could turn your phones off or refrain from using your cameras. They've got professionals videoing and taking photos, so please do that right now, and we thank you for doing that. Also wanted to remind you, you guys were given confetti cannons on the way in, and when Christopher and Shauna are exiting. That's when you are to take those cannons and, you know, make a mess, throw that confetti, cheer a little bit, praise the Lord as they walk by and do that. So thank you for that. So on with the ceremony. We learn from the Bible that the Lord Jesus honored the marriage ceremony with his presence, working there the beginning of his miracles. These miracles indicate that Jesus Christ is the eternal Son of God, the sovereign creator of the universe. It was the wedding ceremony that was first used to demonstrate this glorious fact. And so I ask, who gives Shauna to be married to Christopher? I'm going to pray, but I wanted to do something. I want Christopher, I want you to take Paul's other hand there, and Paul, take your daughter's hand. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the privilege it is just to come to be a part of this special day. We're calling this home into existence. Thank you, Lord, for Jesus, who makes all the difference. Thank you, Lord, for these two individuals that are becoming one. But I thank you for who they are in Christ and the testimony that they have. We just pray, Lord, that you'd be with them all the days of their life, that they would form a home that's welded together in prayer and just empowered by your Holy Spirit. Let them look to you for strength and comfort. And, Lord, I just pray that they would look to you all the days of their life. And we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Now I'm going to turn. We'll let you put their hands in one another. Dad giving the blessing there. And I'm going to turn the ceremony now over to Pastor Paul, Shauna's dad, and he's going to take it from there.
First, I want to welcome everyone here, myself, and I also want to welcome our family and friends who are in the United Kingdom and are watching by video, and others who are watching that couldn't be here today. Thank you for your presence with us as we celebrate the union of Chris and Shauna. Let me pray. Almighty God, we praise you and thank you for marriage. We thank you how it proclaims the gospel, how that you lay down your life for your bride and reconciled us to you through your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that you'll be with us present here today as we celebrate the union of Chris and Shauna. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thinking back, I remember Shauna talking about some guy named Chris. Then you called me and asked for permission to see Shauna a little over 4 years ago. First great step. I remember you saying to me on the phone, "This is what my daddy taught me." As you know, we teach the same things to our sons and our daughter in our home. So good job for heeding your dad's advice. But still, as fathers do, I was thinking, who is this boy who wants to see my daughter? I interviewed you and even asked tough questions, but then I gave my blessing. Then as time passed and I prayed daily, God, if this is the right one, let them fall in love. If not, please stop this relationship fast. As the years passed, I witnessed your care for Shauna, and I witnessed your love grow for one another. I also saw things I never expected. My little girl, the one who didn't like getting dirty, who loved dressing up, doing her hair and decorating her nails, who dreamed of opening a hair salon for upscale women who could get their foo-foo dogs groomed at the same time they were getting their hair styled. My little girl, who didn't like eating the deer I shot. That girl, having met Chris, put on camo. Fired her first gun. I saw it on Facebook. And shot her first deer. And it was a nice one, I have to say. Wow, good first deer. What we do for love. But actually, I know you really did have fun because you were with the one you loved. However, I still wonder if this will last once you're married, if you'll still be going hunting. We'll have to wait and see. She says yes. Most importantly, I saw you both take bold and unpopular stands at JMU, sharing the gospel with your friends with the hopes that they too would know the Savior you both knew and loved. Your love for each other is so very evident, and I'm very happy to be standing here with both of you today as you vow and covenant your separate lives together into one flesh, publicly by God's sovereign grace, before all these witnesses of family and friends. And so we look forward to and consider what Christ will do both in and through you in your lives, we and all these witnesses here. However, we know the pressures of life, financial trials, health problems, problems with children, and our personal desires can expose sin, selfishness, and feelings of entitlement that can prevail in the heart and pull people apart. Your youthful good looks, your feelings and affections for one another are not strong enough to hold your marriage together. Beauty is fleeting, and your feelings will fluctuate. Believe it or not, you'll even have times when you may feel cold towards one another. So on what basis, what foundation can you build your marriage and your new life together? To answer these questions, we must go to the Creator of marriage, God Himself. And so I want to remind you of two foundational truths and what God is doing in marriage. And live by these truths, and God and His Word will hold you up and hold you together. First, remember that marriage was established and ordained by God Himself. After God had created everything, and He declared that everything was good, He saw one thing that wasn't good. And this is what God says. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him." The first man, Adam, found no suitable partner in all creation, having named all the animals. But God, He made a suitable partner, Eve, the first woman. God then brings her to the man, thus giving away the first bride. In the same way, it was God who brought you together through the circumstances of life by His sovereign will. So in Adam and Eve, God set up the first marriage for all mankind. The scripture declares, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." So remember that God, who brought you together and is this day uniting you together in marriage, He was behind the first marriage, and therefore He's behind every marriage, including this marriage. God's role in marriage did not end there in the Garden of Eden. Jesus quoted from the same scripture in Genesis 2, and then applied it to marriage, which shows us that marriage never has changed. It's still the same today as it was back then. And Jesus quoting said, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and his mother, and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate. So build your marriage on this foundational truth. God, by his sovereign hand of providence, has brought you to each other for this very day and this very hour, and is now joining you together in marriage. Remembering these truths will get you through tough financial times, tough nights, disagreements, believe it or not, challenges, trials with children, if the Lord so provides, and even doubts. Remember your marriage was no accident, that he who brought you together will be with you and keep you till death do you part. In short, the God who loved you so much that he stood in your place, taking your judgment at the cross, this loving God brought you together for this great purpose. Build on this unchanging and unshifting rock. Second, remember that God created marriage to put the gospel on display. Paul, quoting from Genesis, writes, so this is quoted over and over again here, therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. And then he adds this, this mystery is profound, and I'm saying that it refers to Christ and the church. Marriage points to something more than just marriage itself. Paul says that it refers to Christ and his church. That is, when he created the first marriage, God patterned it after something he had already planned to do much later in history. God patterned it, the idea of marriage, after the greatest theme of history, the gospel. So what is the gospel, and how does marriage put it on display? We already heard about how God brought the woman Eve to Adam and made them one flesh. Well, the gospel is the good news that man who is separated from God by sin can be brought together with God through Jesus' sacrifice for sin and his subsequent resurrection. The Bible puts it this way in 1 Peter 3:18. For Christ also suffered for sin once for all, the just for the unjust, to bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit. Some of you here today are separated from God by your sin. As Shauna and Chris are being brought together as one, you need to be brought together with God by turning from your sin to God and putting your faith in Jesus Christ. Nothing would make Chris and Shauna happier than to know that in their wedding, you saw the truth of the gospel and were united to God through Jesus Christ. To sum it up, first we see that before marriage, the man and woman are separated individuals. Before salvation, God and man are separated by man's sin. Marriage brings man and woman together in love and establishes a new family. And the gospel brings God and man together through God's love and adds him or her to a new family, the church. So as you're sitting there today, just think about where you are with God. Have you been brought together with God through the Lord Jesus Christ? So how will marriage display to the world the good news of Jesus? Here's another way. Marriage puts on display the gospel through the different roles of the husband and wife. Like the church submits itself to Christ, the call to wives is to be submissive to their husbands. By the way, this isn't popular with the world, but I want to say this, that submission is unifying, right? If there's no submission in marriage, it's just disunity. And so you got to have submission. It's just like if we don't submit to God, then we have disunity with God. And so that role of submission is very precious, God says, in his sight, right? And consider this, that the Lord Jesus Christ himself submitted to the Father. He's equally God, yet he submitted to the Father. He played his role. And the same is true of us. We need to play our roles that God has for us. Ephesians 5, 22 through 24 says, "Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord." So when we're not submitting to our husbands, in other words, we're actually in rebellion towards God, right? "For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and is himself its Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit in everything to their husbands." Shauna, your calling from God is to give up your own rights and desires and submission and in honor to Chris. This will display the way in which believers in Jesus, the church, submit their own desires to Christ, their King. Is this going in and out, this microphone? Yeah. Stay stationary. Now, this isn't popular with the world or pop culture. They don't see it this way. But it is a beautiful thing to serve in humility to your husband. Now, this doesn't mean that you are a doormat. This doesn't mean that you should not give Chris, and I know you will, your input, your opinion, or your needed rebuke. In fact, Chris is only going to grow and thrive if you provide loving help to take up where he is weak and inadequate, so that you may complement and complete him. This will not always be easy, but it means you will respect Chris's role as a leader. By trusting God, you will subject your doubts and your preferences to Chris's leading. And you'll see God will take care of you in that way. When it's hard, remember, Chris, Chris lives in you and will empower, Christ lives in you and will empower you. Trust him and be faithful. Chris, as we continue reading in Ephesians, your calling and responsibility as a husband is no easier. Like Christ died for the church, husbands are called to lay down their lives for their wives in love and service. Ephesians 5:25 says, "Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her." Jesus didn't come to serve, but to serve and to give his life a ransom for many. From coming all the way down to this earth from glory, to washing the disciples' feet, all the way to the cross, Jesus led by serving. Love Shauna like Christ loves you. Love Shauna not merely in word. Love her with actions that leads to sacrifice of yourself, your wants, and your desires. And the goals of your sacrifices for Shauna is not simply to see her desires and wants fulfilled, but as Ephesians 5:26-27 says, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, so that he might present the church to himself in splendor without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. Your goal in sacrificial love is to help Shauna become more holy and faithful to the Lord. You must bathe her in the Word of God, continually putting Christ and his Word before her, praying for her and with her. I suggest devotions together. Your roles in marriage are to be reminders to one another and to the world of how Christ submits, how the church submits to Christ, and how Christ sacrificed himself for his bride. Realistically, though, you will not fulfill these roles perfectly. You will sin against each other and disappoint, but this too provides another opportunity to display the gospel in your marriage. As Jesus forgave you, you have the opportunity to then forgive each other and so put on display to the world the gospel of Jesus Christ. So remember this when you are tempted to harbor bitterness or demand your spouse earn your love and acceptance or demand your spouse be good enough or attractive enough to receive your love. Look back to Jesus' death on the cross and how God looked at you, the ungodly and undeserving sinners that you were. And yet, he came and he laid down his life as a ransom for you to reconcile you to God. Solomon wrote in Ecclesiastes 4:12, "And though a man might prevail against one who is alone, two will withstand him. A threefold cord is not easily broken." So, as a symbol of your marriage and union with Christ, you are now going to weave this unity cord together behind me. The center cord represents Christ, and the other two cords represent both of you. As you weave these cords together, know that it is Christ who is really making you one. And as you trust in him, he will create an unbreakable bond between you two. And now, having been reminded of the purpose of marriage, I will ask you before God, Chris, will you have Shauna to be your wife, to love her, comfort her, protect her, provide for her, and be an example of godliness to her? Will you study, understand, and apply the Word of God to lead your new family? And will you honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her all the days of your life? Shauna, will you have Chris to be your husband, to love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and health? And forsaking all others, keep yourself for him all the days of your life. At this time, you're going to read your vows that you have written for each other. So I have them here. You know which ones are which.
Supposed to tell you how much I love you and why I love you, but I must say it's a little overwhelming to have to do that in such a small book. So here's my best shot, so wish me luck. Shauna, when I first met you, we were so young. Because of our youthfulness, we had so many options. Many charities overcome us now. I'm in a little college in here. It was never a guess for me as to who you would become over these 4 years. Over the years, you have shown countless grace, love, and selflessness throughout our time together. This was most evident to me when I first had my seizure. Everyone who knows me knows how much I love to hunt, and especially COVID hunt. When I had my seizure, I lost my license, and that meant my hunting was going to get extremely limited for the season. At least I thought. Your selflessness and love, you woke up at 3 a.m. to drive over to my house over and over and over again. And I was taking running, and then had to walk several miles to the woods to chase an animal you couldn't have cared less about.
I can't believe it.
But it was never the turkey you cared so much for to get out of bed every morning. It was me. Mm. My passion for the outdoors outweighed the waking up early and the miles of walking. You put my wants so far above yours. And that was the first time it really hit me, the kind of life partner I had with you. And although that situation was the only one I chose to talk about, it was certainly not the only one I could have. I could take the whole night talking about how amazing you are and how grateful I am. But I don't think I will ever be able to express in words how much I love you. And how much you mean to me. You blow me away every day for just the person you are. I love every part of you, the good and the less good. When I see how great you are with children, you're the most incredible mom in the world. When I see how great you are with my family, I can see I'm proud of my home. I see how you prioritize God in your life. I see an amazing, godly mother in your life. And when I see how you are with me, I see a wife who is faithful and loving to God's message. Shauna, I know that life is not always going to be easy, and I also know that there are going to be things that will happen that we could have never prepared for. But truthfully, I'm not worried, because I have the most amazing woman that I've ever walked this earth, and a loving God that will guide us through this tough time. Shauna, I promise with everything I have to be the best man, father, and spiritual leader I can be. I also promise I won't always be perfect, but I promise to never stop trying to be the best husband I can be to you. I promise to protect you, care for you, and cherish you as my bride, as Christ cherishes the church. And I promise to take the words for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, and sickness and health, to love and to cherish till death was part, very literally. My family has always been the ones I love most in life, and I'm so glad I'm able to be a part of it. But I would say the love I have for you is a little different.
I hope so.
And I thank God for it that way. I can honestly say I have never loved someone so much in my entire life. I am truly realizing what God means when He said He created such a special bond between a man and a woman. Even more special than a man and a dog. Also, I know I haven't mentioned how beautiful you are on the outside, because that's not what I find to be the most attractive about you. Of course, you are the most beautiful woman I have ever laid my eyes on. I can't really tell you. They don't know how I ended up with someone like you. But outer beauty will fade with time. What's inside, your heart and your love for me will last forever. With that, I'd like to end with a prayer that I can always come back to during the hard times and good times. Lord, I do not know how I can thank you enough for the many blessings you have. There's not a day that goes by that I don't do something wrong that you have continuously blessed me over and over again. I can honestly say I would give up anything in the world to have Shauna by my side. I pray that any sickness or pain that Shauna will endure in life he doesn't need. I don't care what it is, Lord, I pray that I never see Shauna suffer. And finally, I pray that I leave this world before her, because I don't ever want to face a day that's worse without her.
Everybody knows.
These past 4 years with you have been the best years of my life. You have been my biggest supporter through challenges I never thought I could face. You make me laugh until my belly aches with your sweet and faces. You're an idiot, too. You constantly encourage me to try to be my best in everything I do. You love me and you just love me. You go out of your way to be you do little things, put a smile on my face, like when you come back from the beach and they can shell that you found because you know how much they love collecting shells. Or when you bring me flowers that you picked while hunting because they made you think of you. Or when you show me songs that remind you last minute decide that we should say our vows in front of the audience, even though we were nervous too because we knew how much I wanted to. But above all else, you found me in my faith and hold me to Christ. You show me how important it is to put God at the center of our lives and our relationships. You pray with me, study the Bible with me, and show me what a spiritual leader looks like. Christopher Dean, I could not have asked for a better man, and I'm so blessed that God gave you as my best friend and my life partner. I know that marriage will always be easy and we will always have our ups and downs, but I wouldn't want to go through life with anyone else. You truly are my best friend. I can't wait to start this journey with you, start a family with you, grow old with you, and serve the Lord with you. I love you now and will love you forever.
Okay. Well, you're already turned towards each other, and you requested that you do the traditional vows also. So we'll go ahead and do that. You got each other's hands. And so repeat after me, Chris. I, Chris, take you, Shauna, to be my beloved wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, in sorrow and joy, to love, lead, and cherish. And hereto I pledge you my faithfulness, to show to you the same kind of love that Christ showed to the church when he died for her. And to love you as part of myself. And to love you as part of myself, because in his sight we shall be one. As long as we shall both live or Jesus returns. Now, Shauna, repeat after me.
I Shauna, take you, Chris, to be my beloved husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy. To love, honor, and obey. And hereto I pledge you my faithfulness, and to show the same kind of love that Christ showed when he died for his church. And to love you as part of myself, because in his sight we shall be one, as long as we shall both live, or until Jesus returns. All right. So at this time, we'll exchange the rings. Yeah. All right. As a symbol of your wedding covenant, Chris and Shauna, Chris, take the ring and place it on Shauna's finger as a symbol of the faithful pledge you are making to her. Repeat after me. This ring I give you in token and in pledge of our constant faith and abiding love. Now, Shauna, take the ring and put it on Chris's finger as a symbol of the pledge you're making to him. And repeat after me. This ring I give you in token and in pledge of our constant faith and abiding love. Let me close us in prayer. God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we give thanks to you for your gracious gift of marriage to Chris and Shauna. We are thankful that you changed their hearts and rescued them from sin by forgiving them through faith in Christ, the one who died for them and has now brought them together in marriage to display your love for the church. We look forward to seeing them thrive as a couple for your glory and honor. Lord, help us to be a constant encouragement to their marriage. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and may he be glorified. Amen. Because you have consented together in holy matrimony and have pledged your faithfulness to one another before God and all these witnesses, I now pronounce you that you are husband and wife. Chris, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the distinct pleasure of presenting to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Chris Hughley.
Your love is like a porch swing on Sunday, just as gentle as a summer sunrise. They say it's where the heart is, well, mind who you be, long as I got your hand, I'm fine. Sitting on boxes in the living room, laughing and crying, just staring at them two pink lines. Ooh, yeah. Time to make a little more room in our heads. In the living room, laughing and crying, just staring at them two pink lines. Ooh, yeah. Time to make a little more room in our heads.
Got a few more instructions for you. The ushers are going to dismiss us row by row, but as you're dismissed, you are free to roam about the property, find some shade, or there's going to be like tic-tac-toe, there's croquet, giant Jenga, cornhole. There's water and cookies, refreshments up there next to the barn on the patio. Feel free to help yourself with that. Until we can all go into they'll let you know when you can go into the reception together. But I also want to remind the family to stay close by for pictures as well. So this concludes the ceremony, and the ushers will dismiss you row by row now. Thank you, and God bless.